there is obvious they're partitioning the country. But when has the U.S. ever cared about international law? So that doesn't even appear in the U.S. media.
Yeah,
it's
never hear about
absent,
it.
Right. But we get to the issue that is also still barely covered, which is the U.S. legality of the war in Syria, of the war on Syria. And it's done under the 2001-2003 authorization of the use of military force for Iraq against al-Qaeda, which is still being used by the United States to justify its presence in military conflicts all across the Muslim world.
So this is a justification, Alex, for endless wars. They say that they have the authorization. You just move the goalpost, as it were, and say this is what covers it, okay? I suppose it'll apply to Yemen and Somalia and who knows.
That's like, part of their justification.
It is, okay? So, I mean, you know, it's already a justification, and it doesn't matter the circumstances. It was done once, and it applies to the entire region.
Yeah, let's not forget that Obama is the person that ramped up the U.S. presence in Syria. And so the justification was to fight al-Qaeda. Then Obama comes, and he supports and aids al-Qaeda. ISIS springs up out of al-Qaeda. And now Trump and his generals, and I won't even say Trump, I would say the generals that are running the show there.
You know where I'm going here.
Using it as an excuse to have U.S. troops permanently based in Syria. And Alexander McCursor wrote a very good piece on the Durant about this, explaining that this is really the United States' Plan C option. And no one's talking about the U.S. Plan C, which is actually derived from its McMaster's that many people think is the person that's pushing the U.S. permanent presence in Syria, more out of spite than anything else. So this is a situation. You have a country that's not wanted, not invited. Like Mark said, there's no international Security Council resolution, nothing for the U.S. to be there. But there they are, and they're not going to leave easily.
Timothy, we had Trump when he was speaking publicly at a press conference, quote, get ISIS and go home. Okay, let me give the whole thing. We're there for one reason, to get rid of ISIS and get rid of ISIS and go home. But his generals, I think, as we've been saying for weeks, if not months on this program, say something very different. But